Hi friends, welcome to Finance Studies. I am Aparna. Today I am going to explain you the chapter Sorting Materials into Groups. Matter. What is matter? Matter is anything which occupies space and has mass. There are many properties of matter and matter, air, water, and solid, liquids and gas, all are matter. If you see anything about the material, material, it has properties like everything has a color, shape, order, taste, etc. Everything has a property like color, shape, order, taste, solubility, etc. These are the properties of matter. But why do we sort matter? We sort matter for our convenience. Let's take the example of my school bag. I sort my notes, like the textbooks in one place, and the notebooks in one place, and the workbooks in one place. So that I need not search my whole bags for my books. Just check the notebook place and take my notebook, like that. So it is for our convenience. Now let's see how the matter and the properties differ to the purpose of sorting. We can sort materials by using the properties of matter, or the properties of materials which have matter. Color. If I want to sort, we can sort anything by color, because everything has a specific color. See, this is a black marker, this is a red marker, and this is my blue marker. All are markers, but I can sort this by blues at one side, blacks at one side, and reds at one side, like this. Everything has a specific shape. If you take the example of my duster and a marker, this has a shape. The cuboid shape and the marker, a cylindrical shape. I can sort them like cylindrical at one side and cuboid that shapes at another side. Order. Few materials have smell. The smell is known as the odor. Flowers smell sweet. And few others do not smell sweet. And if you take the third one, they do not smell at all. So we can give them the order. We can segregate by using the order. Like sweet at one place, bad smell at another place, and no smell at another place. Taste. Objects which are edible have a taste. Sugar is sweet, salt is salty. So I can sort them, which objects are salty, go to the salt place, and which are sweet, go to the sugar place. You can segregate like that. Solubility. Now if you come to solubility, we need water to check which is soluble or which is not. Soluble, take water and make anything a powder and mix it. If it disappears and mixes with the water, it is soluble. And if it doesn't, it is insoluble. Take the example of salt and sugar. They are soluble in water. Chalk powder, insoluble in water. But here the problems comes. You also may hear the word miscible and immiscible liquids. What are those? We think that they are same as the solubility with water. No. In this place of solubility, we take the examples only of the solids. But if you come to miscible and immiscible, miscible are liquids which mix with water, and immiscible, they do not mix. Take the example of oil. Is it miscible or immiscible? Immiscible. It doesn't mix with water. pour a layer of oil and water. Oil stays on the top of the water. Conductivity is are objects or materials which conduct heat and or electricity. Take the example of rubber. Heat, yes, but electricity, no. But take the example of my hand. Now if you keep heat, it passes all the heat to my body and I sweat. Malleability is the property that object can be pressed and made into thin sheets. Take the example of iron. It can be made into any shape. Heat it for a long time and you press it, it becomes a thin sheet. Ductility is the property of making the object into thin wires. If you take the example of iron again, or copper, which is also a metal. Copper wires, we use copper wires. So ductility. Lustre, here comes lustre. Lustre is the shine or glow on an object. Take the example of gold. You see a shine on the gold. Roughness is the smoothness of the object. How smooth is the object? Take the example of this. Here it is smooth. Take the example of a rock. And if you press it, means if you wrap it, it is hard. So this is about the roughness. Transparency is the is how much does the object passes the light through it. Transparent object, like take the example of a window pane. The sunlight from outside touches the window pane, again comes inside. Now this is the transparent. Translucent, which allows only some light to pass through it. Example, butter paper. And opaque objects which do not allow light to pass through them at all, like cardboard. Hardness. How hard is the object? Means if we press it, does it get pressed like this? We press it, it is not at all hard. It is soft, it is going. And hard, if you press the marker, no, it is not changing its shape. This is the hardness. Combustibility means if you heat the object, does it burn? Means if you keep flame and put the object on it, does it get fire or not? Take the example of iron and keep it on it. It doesn't get fire. If you put it for a long time also, it doesn't get fire, but it melts. But if you take the example of a paper, if you keep it, it gets flame. Elasticity is the how much can it get pulled. Take the example of a rubber band. Pull it, it goes till here for a small rubber band. But elasticity, iron nail, you pull it how much above, it doesn't change. Volatility means if you keep the object in the sun, does it become vapor? Take the example of petrol. Keep it in sun, it gets vapored. But few other objects which are like solids, this, keep it how much time ever, doesn't change, it doesn't transform into a gas. So this is all about the matter, properties and purpose of sorting. Thank you.